A quick reminder before the video about the modes. As you might know, Ascension's going to launch its pre-patch The Burning Crusade called League Server. Now, this is going to air on the 17th of July, and it's going to have the brunt of the features that's going to be featured in the Burning Crusade patch. I strongly urge you to check this out. In the meantime, I'm taking a small break from the Feltouch series until after the TBC pre-patch League Realm. I've been working on some very cool TBC builds for you guys to check out that I will upload onto the channel very soon. So stay tuned for these 10 out of 10 build videos. Like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on your notifications, and let me know in the comment section down below if you're excited for the upcoming TBC features. You may find the explanatory video on the website on the main page. Now, I'm in the Orc starting zone. As you can see, we have our nice books here. These are class trainers and profession trainer. Now, what I would like you to do, if you're new to Ascension, and obviously watching this video to figure more about the modes, I want you to find this guy, Stony Tark, right? He's in every starting zone. The model might vary depending on faction. Click on this guy. He's going to display all the modes that you are eligible to get at the time being. Now, normally, there's also a Feltouched mode, regarding which I've actually made a separate video. You may find it in the top right corner and down in the description below. However, Feltouched has been removed temporarily. It will be back soon. So, today, we're just going to cover these five modes that you see over here. Iron Man mode, let's begin with that one. Now, the Iron Man challenge is a rather difficult one. You can't group up with other people, as you can see here. You can't mail, trade, or use the auction house. So, no item trade whatsoever, or gold for that matter, between your character and any other character in the realm. You do not gain profession experience from crafting or gathering. No refer a friend boosting, which is a feature that's in the donated shop on the Ascension website, which is basically an item you purchase, and then you can use it to increase the level of friend each time you level up two times. You increase your friend's level by one, and you also share an experience boost across the board. And last but not least, the most important part of Iron Man Challenge, you can't die. You die, the character's over. You start from scratch, it's game over. That's the whole gist of the mode. Now, you will be eligible for PvP just like any other character, with a range of three levels, and other Iron Men will be the only ones who can engage you in one versus one combat. So you don't have to worry about other players who are not playing Iron Men to come and kill you. Upon reaching level 60 successfully, you're going to get this bad boy. There we go. This is the mount reward that you would play this challenge for, apart from the challenge itself. Now, next one down the line is Survivalist mode, which is very similar to Iron Man Challenge because it's essentially the same. The only stark difference is that you can group up with other survivalists. So imagine an Iron Man light mode, so to speak, whereby you can group up with and trade with other survivalists, not other players or other normal players, but other survivalists. Apart from that, it's pretty much the same, including the rewards. I would recommend, if you're new to Ascension, well, first of all, go and try out the game, play it normally, but if you'd really like to head-on take a challenge, I would recommend you to get a couple friends and try out the Survivalist, especially for the reward, because it's the same. Only do Iron Man mode if you just want that extra challenge for your own reasons, right? From a technical and practical standpoint, it doesn't make much more sense to go for Iron Man over Survivalist. It's easier here. Now, Wildcard mode. This is essentially a random ability drafting mode whereby you start with four random abilities, and what this mode does is essentially giving you a random ability each time you've got two ability essences, or if it's a one ability essence ability, then each time you've got one ability essence. You get one ability essence per level, and most useful spells and abilities and skills, including the talent abilities, are two essence points. Now, coming with the TBC Burning Crusade pre-patch and later on the realm itself, this is going to change. There's a dynamic ability essence system that's going to take over. But digress, that's better saved for another video. I'm going to make a separate guide for for TBC pre-patch, which is going to be live. The League server, the so-called League server, is going to be live at the pre-patch. We're bearing most of the features in about 4 days from this video, on Friday, 17th of July. Now, back to the topic, wildcard mode. You get a random ability each time you have enough essences, so mostly every two levels. You're left with 4 ability essences at level 60, and upon reaching 60 in this challenge, you get the Chaotic Rune Saber mount. Draft mode. Draft mode is essentially the same kind of concept, but it's a bit milder. As you might know from MOBA games or other sort of games where team play is involved and each team picks characters or heroes of their own, at random, as the name suggests, but when it's draft mode, you get to draft 1 out of 3 or 5. Now, this is very similar, that you get 3 cards each time you're eligible for a new ability, and you get to pick one of those, and the other two just go away, disappear. In the beginning, you start with 4 drafts, meaning you get 4 sets of cards of 3, from which you end up choosing 4 abilities in total. Now, up until level 10, you won't get any other drafts because those 4 first abilities are going to cover you till you're level 10. Starting from level 10, you'll also start getting talent points, obviously, and you'll also be eligible to have talent abilities in your draft. Again, same logic, you do get these items that allow you to redraft certain abilities that you might not like. Anything you don't fancy, you use that item on, and it will give you a brand new draft of 3 spells, and then you can pick one of those, or you could opt to close the window, in which case you will just have wasted the item, but at least you didn't waste the spell that you wanted to replace, because the way it works is that you first get a selection of the 3 spells that you're going to eventually replace your old spell with, and then you get the 3 spells that you want to get rid of in order to get the first spell you've selected. So it's not the other way around, as in you're not risking losing a spell that you might not really want to lose, but let's say you end up with really great abilities in the second draft where you pick. That's not the case. You first pick the new spell, then you pick the spell to get rid of, to replace it with. Now, this challenge gives you a pet, a companion. This little hand right here crawls around. Right. Resolute mode. This is your Blizz-like experience. All experience rate is brought down to x1. The very vanilla-like experience, so to speak, apart from the fact that it's classless. Now, the rewards are very good. 5 pieces of dungeon gear, 2 pieces of raid gear, 250 marks of ascension, which is an ascension currency, that you can also use, by the way, to get those re-rolling items in draft mode, among other ways of spending this currency. Then you get mystic orbs and runes, which are used for the random enchant system of ascension, which are typically small effects that you can tie up to your items, just like enchantments as you would. They don't replace World of Warcraft enchantments, but what they do is, as if, imagine each one of your items having some sort of a unique talent-like effect on them, and they're often so very unique. So these are used to extract these effects that you get from world drops on items that you might not want to really use, but you extract that random enchant, put it into your collection, and then you use the other resource to put that effect onto an item that you desire. So it's a currency that you use for random enchants, basically put. Now, the reward for this one is rather cute. As you can see, it's a really nice little foxy. Very cute indeed. But as I said, this is very difficult, because we're talking about a world where you can level up to 60 in about 5 to 6 hours in the normal mode. This is going to take you the normal vanilla-like amount. So bear that in mind. This is by no means the hardest challenge, it's just probably the longest one, unless you keep on dying each and every time in Iron Man or Survivalist. I would say the reward to risk or time investment ratio, and in terms of what's worth a bit more, because you would want a mount, right? Mount is a nice reward to get, especially if you're fairly new. Again, I would recommend you play the game normally, get the gist of it, and figure out what you like to do, what kind of builds you'd prefer, and then go into one of these modes. Preferably starting with Wildcard. I would say Draft, but Draft only gives you a companion, so for that sweet, sweet mount, you could start with Wildcard, and then maybe do Survivalist for a second mount. And if you're feeling really, really confident, then you can go for Iron Man. Or if you feel a bit masochistical, then you can go for Resolute, I suppose. Even though the rewards are nice. It just takes so long. Now, as you can see, we have some items here also. Dice of Destiny. This enables the wildcard mode. Spell Draft deck. You can use this item to reroll the initial four ability drafts infinitely. You can keep doing this forever. So if you're not happy with what you've got within your first four drafts, just reroll it. But bear in mind, this will reroll all of them that you've got so far. So if you've already got, let's say, two spells out of your four drafts, so the first two drafts are complete and you're happy with those, let's say Frostbolt and Holy Light, right? It's a nice spell, damage dealing and nice heal. Yet, you got something not so great on your third draft, and again, something less than ideal on your fourth, and you're telling yourself, hey, I could do better than this, I could get a better combination. Now, if you choose to reroll then, you'll also lose your Frostbolt and your Holy Light. They're not going to stay. It rerolls the whole thing. And again, you can't use this item beyond level 1, because then you will have learned you will have got drafts. This is only for the initial first four drafts. Now, this allows you to enable Resolute mode, and this removes the wildcard mode, and you won't be able to re-enable it afterwards. Now, if you're bored of the mode and you just want to continue, you know, without it, without random abilities, you don't find it fun, you could use this. But if you've made it that far with that character already, I mean, you get limited amount of resets on your abilities and or talents. First 10 levels, this is free, the ability, that's perfectly fine. So if you don't like the gist of wild card within the first 10 levels, then by all means, use it and then reset the spells before you become level 10. But afterwards, you're going to have, as you can see, 3 ability purges and 3 talent purges. Now, these enable you to completely wipe out all the ability essences used, and likewise this for the talent essences, so you can rebuild your character from scratch. Let's say you're level 60, you build anymore, you use both of these, you get all your talents and all the abilities from scratch at your disposal. Well, one thing to note and worth mentioning here is that there's a Chromie NPC in main cities, and sometimes that NPC gives you a free purge every now and then, not too often. Aside from those, you will have to purchase these with in-game gold. It's not that expensive, but it's not that cheap either. It's kind of a trade-off. You're going to have to spend more time in order to make a new build that you'd like to spend more time in, if you get what I mean. Now,
THAT'S ENOUGH!
You can, of course, also donate and get these purges on the website. And you can also get scrolls that allow you to unlearn certain talents abilities one by one. You get a limited amount of these throughout your leveling process. And after that, it will cost you gold, a specific fixed amount of gold, to unlearn single abilities or single talents one at a time. Now, if you try to do this for all your abilities or your talents, it's going to be significantly more expensive than just purging them, even if you bought the purges with money. So only do that for very minor changes to your existing build, I would recommend. That pretty much sums up all the modes. Again, mentioned earlier, if you're interested in the Fel Touch, which is a very unique game mode where you level up super fast in about 30 minutes up to 60, and it's all about PvPing, check out the video. Again, it's on the top right corner or in the video description below, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching the video. I hope it was helpful. Please like the video, subscribe, and leave a comment below regarding what you might like to see next. And especially if you're new, let me know what areas you would like covered. Please make sure to check out the official Ascension videos covering all these topics and all the teasers they have over at their channel in the top right corner, and I'm leaving a link down in the description below as well. Also, don't forget to check out the Discord channel, Twitch channel, and Twitter. Links in description. Have fun playing. I'll see you next time.